Yes.
Praise to the Trinitarian God. Praise to the one who came and rescued us from our sins.
Amen.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Lord Jesus Christ is identified in the Bible as not only the Messiah, but He is the eternal Word of God.
Yes.
He is the eternal Son of God who came and died on the cross for sin of mankind.
That's right.
Christian scripture teaches us we all sin against God.
Yes.
All of us. And for all of us to stand in front of Holy God once again, we all need to repent from our sins with the blood of Jesus, what He did on the cross.
Yes.
According to Christian scripture, eternal Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ took up human nature and lived among us.
Yes.
Approximately 30 years.
30 years.
And that Lord Jesus Christ, for the sin of mankind, nailed Himself on the cross so that people can make right with God.
Yes.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ. Because only because Lord Jesus Christ, we can stand in front of Holy God.
Yes.
Because only with Lord Jesus Christ, we can call God our Father.
That's right.
Thanks to Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise be.
It is a historical fact that Jesus died on the cross by crucifixion.
Yes.
According to Bible.
Yes. No one doubts that Jesus died on the cross. It is indeed a historical fact. We know this from scholars, we know this from the Gospels. All of them agree on this fact that Jesus died on the cross. We know this from other scholars such as Josephus, who agree that Jesus lived and was crucified. We know that Jesus died on the cross.
Bible from the beginning in Genesis chapter 3 tells us Messiah Jesus needed to die on the cross. He's gonna die. All the prophets tells us Messiah is going to die. Jesus turns up around first century and then He tells us He is going to die. And after His death, resurrection is going to take place. Jesus dies on the cross. He doesn't stay dead, yet He resurrects on the third day.
Yes.
It's a historical fact.
That's right.
That Jesus died on the cross. And as we expressed, He did not stay as a dead man. He is alive.
Yes.
According to Islamic scripture, He is still alive.
That's right.
And according to Christian scripture, He is still alive. Christian faith based and give birth to the itself because death and resurrection of Messiah.
Yes.
Throughout centuries, people always thought, historic and theologically, death of Jesus has its meaning. And that meaning is about men and women to stand in front of Holy God on the day of judgment as righteous people. Of course, people comment on His resurrection. People, when we look at the Bible, we see what was the understanding of Messiah for Christian, for Jewish people. Their expectation was little bit different, yet they knew Messiah is going to come, rule and reign.
That's right. The Jews had a specific understanding of what the Messiah was going to be, and they would not have created a movement around a Messiah that was crucified unless something else had happened. Jesus was crucified. He was put on the cross. What a first century Jew expected was a Messiah that was going to come and violently overthrow the Roman government in the first century. But what they saw was not that with Jesus, but they saw Christ crucified on the cross. And no one who went to the cross lived. The cross was an instrument invented by the Assyrians and perfected by the Romans. You didn't go to the cross and just seem to have died. You didn't go to the cross and half die. Everyone who went to the cross died. Meaning that if Jesus actually did go to the cross, Jesus actually died. And no first century Jew looking at Jesus would have created a movement around him, a messianic movement, unless something else had happened. Because other messiahs had come before him and had died on the cross. And other messiahs came after him and died on the cross. But no movement was made around them. Only Jesus, because something else occurred after he actually did die.
He's gonna make him
hard. I disagree that he died on the cross, because this teaching actually is degrading to the holiness, forgiveness, loving, justice of God. And I will say why. If God sent his own son to die for other people's sin, he's actually contradicting his own teaching to Ezekiel and Isaiah, because he teaches them that the father wouldn't share the guilt of the son, and the son shouldn't share the guilt of the father. And he would be a criminal God to send somebody innocent to die for other sins, which make him unjust by accepting the blood of God, blood of the son on. Because it make him a bloody God, not forgiver. Because God created us, and we have the ability to sin. But as long as we repent, God must forgive us without asking for price tag for his forgiveness. That's why he is all loving.
Let me respond to that. Let me respond to that. I'm going to respond to your first point.
Okay.
I am disappointed that speaker's going to once again, without any shame, Islamic Dawah thinks Allah is Santa Claus. Without any shame, Islamic Dawah treats God as Marks and Spencer. Without any shame, Islamic Dawah treats God as Amazon. That whatever you want to do, Allah is going to give it to you. No, maybe your God does, but my God is holy.
Yes.
Amen. Man and woman sin against God.
Yes, that's right. Yes. Yes.
When man and woman sin against holy God, we separated from his
That's
holiness.
Right.
For us to be only made right with God, that sin must be paid. Sin is not paid by any human being.
That's right.
Sin is not paid by my father.
No.
Sin is not paid by my son.
No.
Sin is paid by the eternal Son of
yes.
God, who is fully man, fully God.
Who actually
is fully God, fully man.
Right.
And is perfect and good enough.
And who actually died on the cross for our sins, so that we can be united with him for eternity in heaven. He actually died and actually rose again.
So you accept that the sin is bigger than the forgiveness and justice and the love of God. Because he's a criminal God and he wants the blood to forgive you.
Hold on a minute!
He is not holy.
Wait 1 second.
He's not holy.
Don't ever call my God criminal God. As you stand in front of him as a criminal.
No.
We are all criminals.
That's right.
We stand in front of holy God as a criminal. Do not ever call my God like that. As you stand in front of holy God as a criminal, you need a perfect judge to punish you from your sins. And that perfect judge tells you, I am willing to die for your sins because I love you.
Yes.
Because he loves you.
Yes.
He wants to be with you.
Yes.
And his son says, I am willing to give up my life.
That's right.
His son is not criminal. His son wasn't criminal. But he became a criminal.
That's right.
Because of you, because of me, because of
That's
all
right.
our sins.
Thank you very much. You're admitting that God is the biggest sinner by sending his own son to die. And he couldn't He couldn't. Your God couldn't forgive you for free. So he wants somebody to die. And he chose to incarnate, to beget himself, so he becomes son and father at the same time, to die for it. Besides, Jesus teach that he will be seated on the right-hand side of God, of the Mighty One, which have no God beside him, or no God before him.
Can you listen? Jesus seated on the right hand of God?
Can you listen?
That God is going to judge you. Is Jesus seated on the right hand of God? That God is going to tell you, you are Antichrist. As I told you, brother, Jesus is not McDonald's.
No.
Jesus is not Marks and Spencer.
No.
Jesus is not Amazon, and he's not Santa Claus. Gives you what you want.
That's right.
My God is holy
yes.
and just.
Yes.
My God is holy
yes.
and just. You are criminal standing in front of holy God
That's
to
right.
be judged, and you will be judged for that. So, can you please respond to the complaint?
My name is Sayyid F11. My name is Sayyid F11. Your God is unholy, and just, and merciful, and loving, and forgiving. He's a bloody God who wants salvation only by the blood of his own son, which make him a Dracula. Your God is a Dracula, no more than that.
My God, if you repent, he will forgive you. And discredits their own scripture by calling my God Dracula.
Yes.
My question.
God is can forgive everything. Why Allah is punishing me for right. your sins, son? Today, don't stand next to me
every
and
soul,
sin no more.
Every
I don't
will,
want your
every
sin.
Every soul will pay for each
Adam,
action. None.
That discredits Islam. If every soul pays for its action, why Christians
Ezekiel 18, number 20.
Contradicting
your own Jesus teaching. The Lord our God is one. He didn't teach incarnation. He didn't teach that he became himself. The Lord our God is one. How many God we have? Father God,
one God,
Jesus God, two God. Yahweh God and Jesus God. How many? And I already said,
For us to say that the first century Jews might have just made up the idea about the resurrection. That is nonsensical, and is dishonest to historical facts that we know about first century Jews. The first century Jews could have no more made up the idea about a bodily resurrection than you can make up the idea of a new color right now. The first century Jews, most of the people would have followed the Pharisees, meaning that they would have believed that there is a resurrection after heaven, a life after death. However, they would have had no conception of a bodily resurrection immediately after death like Jesus underwent. We see this in John chapter 11, when Martha asks Jesus what happened to her brother Lazarus, and Lazarus, and Jesus says, "I will raise Lazarus from the dead today." And she says, "Lord, I know that you will raise him on the last day," showing that she does not understand. Likewise, the disciples again and again and again are unable to understand Jesus when he says that he will die and raise again. A first century Jew would not have been able to make up the idea of an immediate bodily resurrection. They would have had to see it and then write about it.
Let me
and
give you,
as they saw crucified Jesus, as they saw risen Jesus with his wounds, they understood the bodily resurrection. It wasn't only the bodily resurrection. It was also enemy of Christians called Paul. He didn't like Christians, but because of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, he put his faith on Jesus. Also James, who was the brother of Jesus, his conversion took place after the death and resurrection of Jesus. Something unique happened to those people who did not follow Jesus in the ministry of Jesus, yet they start following him after his resurrection.
The Jews could not have made up the idea of resurrection. Pagans also couldn't have made up the idea of resurrection. Plato had no conception of the resurrection either. So neither Jews nor Greeks could have made up the idea of resurrection.
And he wants mercy.
With converts, we had Paul and James converting to Christianity early on. The only thing that could cause enemies of Christianity to convert to Christianity is if they saw something. That's where we've been so far.
As you stand next to us on your ladder, can you tell us, where is the body of Jesus today?
Yes.
Simple question. Where is the body of Jesus?
And you allow me to carry on.
Answer the question. Where is the body of Jesus?
God saved Jesus from the crucifixion and raised him to heaven. And here we are waiting for his second coming. As a person, any human, he died once. They don't die twice. So he didn't die the first time because God raised him, and he didn't allow him to be humiliated and die like a criminal on the cross.
So who died then?
Why?
Who died? Who died on the cross? Who died on the cross? Who died on the cross? Somebody else died on the cross.
Let me tell you why.
How convenient. Somebody else died on the cross. That doesn't make any historical sense. We know that there is an empty tomb. We know that there is an empty tomb. All four Gospels say that there is an empty tomb. Up to the year 70 AD, people who agreed that there was an empty tomb, the Jewish Sanhedrin, were alive. The Romans and the Sanhedrin could have given, the Sanhedrin and the Roman government could have given a body from the empty tomb, but they didn't. We know that there was an empty tomb. And so if somebody else died on the cross, we are asked to assume that Jesus somehow was able to move a 2-ton stone by himself, dispose of 2 Roman guards by himself, move a body by himself, so that there was an empty tomb. That does not make any sense historically.
So,
here's the bottom line. Allah did not want to touch Jesus, and Allah did not want to kill him, because he did not want his prophet to suffer. But Allah was quite happy to watch Muhammad to go through that suffering, where Aisha states he never seen anyone to suffer as Muhammad.
Let's stay on
Can
the subject.
You tell me? On the
Let
subject.
Let me give you reference verses
on
from
the
Bible. Which contradict your talking?
Someone has died on the beside Jesus, on God the behalf of Jesus.
Mercy.
Where is the body?
Not the blood.
Yeah.
Hosea.
Where is the body of that someone else?
Matthew. Nine numbers.
Where is the body
13.
Of that someone
Matthew.
Else?
Matthew.
Okay.
12,
we don't have the body of someone else. Here's the thing.
Seven. Verse number seven, number 10.
Hebrew. Here's the thing.
Number five.
Since
verse
we don't
number
have
seven.
Since
Hebrew.
We don't have the body 10. Of someone else.
Verse number
Brother,
five and number
let's
18.
Let's go to the story
God
of the crucifixion.
Yes.
Mercy, how did people got crucified?
You,
I am on the cross.
People.
Nailing. I am on the cross. Got nailed. Okay, what I tell? Bring me hot chocolate. I am enjoying my crossing part. Or would I say, get me out of this.
You would have done anything to get out of being crucified. When they crucified you, they put a nail here in your wrist. There is a nerve right here in your wrist. It's the same nerve that runs through your funny bone. And so you have a nail driven through your wrist. It feels like a nail being driven through your funny bone. You will do anything to get off that cross, including saying that you are not that person. If it was somebody else pretending to be Jesus, you would say real fast that you are not Jesus.
How can you claim?
What would be the possibility
how can you claim
for that person?
When, if I accept Jesus, that he died on the cross. If I accept he died on the cross, why he shouted, complaining to his father, why you forsaken me?
Yeah,
he didn't accept it.
Because
if he's a believer, he would accept the will of God.
I'm going to respond. So, if you said, if I accept that Jesus died on the cross, guys, watch out! Watch out! This person, with statement that he, if he's agrees that Jesus died on the cross, he's becoming apostate. And we all know what Allah says about apostate. Accepting the death of Jesus on the cross means denying Quran and agreeing with the history and with the previous books. Here's the thing. Jesus, I'm answering the question, get on the line and listen. Jesus was on the cross. Jesus was on the cross as a criminal, thanks to sin of you, thanks to sin of me, thanks to sin of everyone. It was our sins put the eternal word of God on the cross.
Amen.
It was our sins put the eternal Son of God on the cross.
Okay.
When he was on the cross, what he said, brother, let's open the Bible, let me read what he said for us while he was on the cross. Psalm 22. Can you read the Psalm?
So, this is what you just said.
You ask the question, wait for the answer. Psalm 22.
One of my favorite psalms.
This is what Jesus said. Jesus gave the description for his crucifixion as he claimed to be the Messiah while he is on the cross. If you read all of it for us, brother.
Psalm 22. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me? So far from the words of my groaning. Oh my God, I cry out by day, but you do not answer. By night, and am not silent. Yet you are enthroned as the Holy One. You are the praise of Israel, and you, our fathers, put their trust. They trusted, and you delivered them. They cried to you and were saved, and you, they trusted, and were not disappointed. For I am a worm and not a man, scorned by men and despised by the people. All who see me mock me. They hurl insults, shaking their heads. He trusts in the Lord. Let the Lord rescue him. Let him deliver him, since he delights in him.
How he deliver him
and
save him as long as he was cursed.
Yet you brought me out of the womb. You made me trust in you, even at my mother's breast. From birth I was cast upon you. From my mother's womb you have been my God. Do not be far from me, for trouble is near and there is no one to help. Many bulls surround me. Strong bulls of Bashan encircle me. Roaring lions that tearing their prey open their mouths wide against me. I am poured out like water. All my bones are out of joint. My heart has turned to wax. It has melted away within me.
I don't remember.
My strength has dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You lay me in the dust of death. Dogs have surrounded me. A band of evil has encircled me. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. People stare and gloat over me. They divide my garments among them and cast lots for my clothing.
Your Bible.
Jesus was at the cross. Jesus said, my God, why have you forsaken me?
Yeah, why?
And my brother
Jesus said that his sin is bigger than his love and mercy and holiness. That's why.
Your God is a bloody God, giving the description. I am the one who Psalm 22 is talking about.
Dracula, yes.
I am the one who has been prophesied centuries ago, who is going to come and die on the cross for your sins.
Yes.
And he breathed his last breath.
Yes.
And he died. Yet he did not stay dead. He was resurrected on the third day.
That's right.
Yeah. He was resurrected on the third day. He rose and reigns today.
Yes.
Let me ask you, you were three days alive. He was alive after he died for three days to pay for your sins.
Go and sin has not judged your life. God already gets the price, the blood. Sin has not judged your life.
This is an invitation
and admission.
Admission
that your God is bloody.
It is shame.
Shame on you and your God.
Shame and shameful to Islamic Dawah.
God of love. He forget his love.
He demonstrated his love with the cross.
That's right.
It is
for you, brother.
It is
and for me.
I don't understand.
He demonstrated
God of Christians
at the cross.
Who loved mankind so much.
That's
that
right.
he was willing to go through that suffering. He was willing to demonstrate his love for sinful man and woman. Yet today, at Speaker's Corner, Islamic Dawah Team, without any shame, denies the historical event of crucifixion.
That's right. That's right.
Without any shame,
that's right.
Islamic Dawah Team cannot tell us who died on the cross, while Islam tells us.
That's right.
No one can take the burdens of other person.
Yet, somehow,
Allah put someone else
instead of Jesus. Yeah.
That goes against the teachings of Islam.
Yes.
So far we saw Christian faith based on the death of and resurrection of Jesus, because
43.
Understanding
God
of Messiah on the resurrection
to Jesus,
we saw
to save
people could not
to let
make it up
die on the cross.
That's right.
Bodily resurrection unless they have seen it.
That's right.
We saw people who did not follow Jesus, followed and become a Christian after
the Lord
death and resurrection of
that's
Jesus.
Right.
Save. He is anointed.
And
he will
what is the
him
another thing makes you convinced that resurrection of Jesus
will answer Jesus?
Wait,
because he is dead.
Yeah. We are talking about the resurrection just now. Right.
That's
you
right.
Will be given. Not
the apostles all, it is historical fact that the apostles endured terrible death. We know that James, for instance, was thrown from the temple and then stoned to death. We know that Stephen was stoned to death. Bartholomew is said to have been skinned alive, and yet we have no evidence of any recanting whatsoever. None of the early Christians who said to have seen the risen Lord recanted their faith. If they were lying about Jesus and said that he had risen to Peter and then to the 12, after that, he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers.
Amen.
At the same time, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep.
some of them are still alive. If you don't believe me that Jesus is resurrected, go and ask those some of the 500 people. Yet, no one testifies. Those some of 500 people confirm that Jesus did not resurrect. There is no account of that. As historically, Jesus died on the cross, and there is a very good case that the resurrection took place on the third day.
That's right.
Helps us to put our faith in a historical foundational Christian faith.
That's right. For a millennium, ancient Jews had been celebrating Shabbat, the Lord's Day, on Saturday. And then all of a sudden, in the first century AD, we see them switching that day to Sunday. What would cause first century Jews, pious, living according to the Torah, to change the day on which the Sabbath was celebrated? Only something as shocking as an immediate bodily resurrection on a Sunday could do that.
Let me give you
the number of women
Jesus after he died.
Allow me, please, for changing their day of Sabbath to Sunday. So there are lots of reasons to see not Jesus only died on the cross by crucifixion for the sin of man, yet he resurrected on the third day.
Yes.
Let's just summarize these 12 reasons again.
Yes. So the reasons why we know that the death of Jesus was historical and that his resurrection was historical is that the Jews could not have made up the idea of the bodily resurrection of Jesus, is that those who went to the cross always died, is that there was an empty tomb, and everyone agrees about this, there was never any body produced, is that the first people to see Jesus risen from the dead were women, which you would not say if you were trying to convince people to join your religion, is that people who are against Christianity converted to Christianity early on because they had seen and experienced something.
Let me give you the contradiction of the number.
This is how we know that our faith is not based on fantasy or conjecture, but our faith is based on historical facts. That we are not a faith that is based on mysticism, but we are based on fact, historical fact. It is a fact that Jesus died on the cross and rose from the dead. It is historical fiction that Jesus just seemed to die on the cross. It is historical facts that he died, that he was raised from the dead on the third day, and that we can now trust in him and believe in him because our God is just, our God is loving, and our God is merciful.
How can you say that?
And as a result, we can believe in Jesus and give our sins to him.
As on the cross,
As
death and resurrection of Jesus tells us something very important.
Yeah.
People, as we stand at speaker's corner, we are all sinners in front of Holy God.
That's right.
We are all criminals in front of God.
He is the biggest sinner.
Jesus Christ, who is the perfect sacrifice for mankind, was willing to die for us as a criminal,
that we can be made right with God.
Thanks to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to him.
Jesus Christ gives us eternal life.
Yes.
Thank the Lord Jesus Christ.
He died, offers us eternal life, his quality life.
Yes.
That Lord Jesus Christ tells us, repent and put your faith on the cross. Cross is just a gracious act of God.
Yes.
Cross, just a loving action of God.
That's right.
As we were all sinners, God demonstrated his love for us. By dying on the cross for us, so that wrong. People can wrong. Be wrong. Right of course, with
that's
God.
Right. Praise God. Praise God. We he loves you this. And wants and you to come to him. And he's want. Waiting for anyone here, even you, sir, to accept him, to accept Jesus into your life so that your sins may be forgiven.
Him. I accept
Amen.
Him.
Amen.
Thank you, brother. Yes.